Dear students, the next test which we consider is Durbin-Watson D test. Durbin-Watson D test or D statistic. Durbin-Watson D statistic. This test is so popular that it is routinely computed and it is reported in most of the econometric softwares along with the TF, chi-square, etc. Now, the definition of D is equal to sigma u hat t minus u hat t minus 1 square. T is equal to 2 to n divided by sigma u hat t square. T is equal to 1 to n. This is D. So D is simply the ratio of sum of squared differences in successive residuals to RSS. This is RSS. This is the sum of squared differences in residuals. Now, as I told you, Durbin-Watson D is so popular that it is reported along with the TF, chi-square, etc. in most of the econometric softwares. And Durbin-Watson D can be applied if and only if the classical assumptions about the regression model is satisfied. So to refresh your memory, let me say what are the assumptions that must be satisfied to use Durbin-Watson D. One is, the model should include an intercept. The model should include an intercept. That means this test cannot be applied if there is regression through the origin model. The second is, it is assumed that X's are non-stochastic. Non-stochastic or fixed in repeated samples. So, to implement this test, we cannot use lagged values of the dependent variable. X is assumed to be non-stochastic. A third assumption is, ut is generated by AR1. Ut is equal to rho ut minus 1 plus epsilon t. Ut is generated by AR1 scheme. Ut is equal to rho ut minus 1 plus epsilon t. Now, a fourth assumption is ut is assumed to be normally distributed. Ut is assumed to be normally distributed. And a fifth assumption is model should not include lagged values of dependent variable like yt minus 1 or yt minus 2, etc. This assumption that X is non-stochastic means there should be no lagged values of dependent variable as independent variable along with the other explanatory variables. The situation in which we will encounter lagged values of dependent variable as independent variables will be considered later. This is a case of autoregressive models. Yt regressed on yt minus 1, yt minus 2, etc. So, then there should be no missing observations. No missing observations. So, to implement the Durbin-Watson D to detect autocorrelation, our model should satisfy classical assumptions. That is, no, there will be an intercept, X non-stochastic, AR1 scheme, normality of U, no lagged values of dependent variable, missing observations should not be there, etc. Now, unlike TF or chi square, the exact sampling distribution of B cannot be derived. You know that for hypothesis testing using any test statistics, the sampling distribution of the test statistics must be known. But in the case of D, the exact distribution of D is unknown. That means we cannot derive the exact sampling distribution of D statistics because D statistics is related in a complicated way to the number of explanatory variables present in the data. So unlike T, F, chi-square, etc., there are no unique critical values to accept or reject the null hypothesis. We know that in the case of T, Z, chi-square, F, etc., to accept or reject a null hypothesis, we have unique critical values. This is not true in the case of Durbin-Watson D statistics. But Durbin and Watson derived a lower bound DL and an upper bound DU. But Durbin and Watson derived a lower bound DL and an upper bound DU such that if the D calculated from the sample, if the D calculated from the sample lie outside these intervals, a decision can be made regarding the presence or absence of autocorrelation. So our decision about whether there is autocorrelation or not depends on the value of D in relation to DL and PU. And as we will see later, this D values depends only on two things. One is N, the sample size. The next is XS, number of explanatory variables. And you go through any book on econometrics, you will see the D values, DL and DU, for N between 6 to 200 and X up to 20. That is, if you consult any book on econometrics, you will see DL and DU values for 1% critical value, 5% critical value, for N between 6 to 200, X up to 20. That I will explain once more. Anyway, the value of D, as we are going to show, lie between 0 and 4. This is the range of D. Always remember this. The range of D is between 0 and 4. And I will explain the mechanism of accepting or rejecting H0 with an example. And Durbin-Watson D is applicable if and only if the classical assumptions are satisfied. Classical assumptions are satisfied. That is very important. These assumptions are satisfied by the model. Exact sampling distribution of D is unknown, and our decision about autocorrelation or not is based on an upper limit DU and a lower limit DL. That I will explain later. And the range of D is between 0 and 4. This must be remembered always. Let us see why it is. So we expand this formula. D is equal to sigma u hat t square, sigma u hat t square plus sigma u hat t minus 1 square plus minus 2 sigma u hat t, u hat t minus 1. Because it is a minus b square. So sigma u hat t square plus sigma u hat t minus 1 square plus, so minus 2 sigma u hat t minus 1 divided by sigma u hat t square. Expanding this formula. Here it is 1 to n. Here it is ut square, ut minus 1 square. And when we take the sum t 1 to n minus 1, 1 to n minus 1, this is t, this is 2 to n, this is t is equal to 1 to n minus 1, this is u hat t, u hat t minus 1, 2 to n minus 1. That is not very important for us because this will be calculated automatically by the software. Now, as you can see, this sigma u hat t square and sigma u hat t minus 1 square are different by only one observation. So they are almost equal. Sigma u hat t square is almost equal to sigma u hat t minus 1 square. They are different by only one observation. So that we can write this d as 2 sigma u hat t minus 1 square. I substitute the value u hat t minus 1 square for sigma u hat t square. So 2 sigma u hat t minus 1 square by sigma u hat t square. Sigma u hat t square minus 2 sigma u hat t minus 1 by sigma u hat t minus 1 square. Sigma u hat t minus 1 square. Because by using this, sigma u hat t square is replaced by sigma u hat t minus 1 square in all the terms. Now, this can be, so when I substitute the value, this equals become almost equal like this. So this is almost equal to 2 into, these two terms will cancel, 1 minus 2 is taken out, sigma u hat t minus 1 by sigma u hat t minus 1 square, t minus 1 square. And as we have derived and described earlier, this quantity is rho hat in the regression of u hat t on u hat t minus 1. So d is equal to 2 into 1 minus rho hat. D is equal to 2 into 1 minus rho hat. Rho hat. So d is between, so d is 2 into 1 minus rho hat. Now suppose that, and we know that the value of rho hat is, well, the value of rho or rho hat is between plus 1 and minus 1, because it is a correlation coefficient. Now let us see the case 1. This rho hat is equal to 0. Then we know that d is 2. D is 2. Rho hat 0 means there is no autocorrelation. Rho hat 0 means, you know, this is the quantity that is obtained from regressing u hat t on u hat t minus 1. Rho hat 0 means there is no autocorrelation. So if d is 2 or near to 2 in an application, we will conclude that there is no autocorrelation. Now suppose that rho hat is equal to plus 1, then d is, if rho hat is equal to plus 1, d is 0. D is 0. So in an application, if the value of d is 0 or close to 0, then we will conclude that there is evidence of positive autocorrelation. there is evidence of positive autocorrelation. And if rho hat is negative 1, d is equal to 4. So in an application, if the value of d is 4 or close to 4, we will conclude that there is evidence of negative autocorrelation. So this is b. The range of d is between 0 and 4, given from this. D 0 means, or close to 0 means no autocorrelation. Sorry, there is evidence of positive autocorrelation. 2 or close to 2, there is evidence of no autocorrelation. 4 or close to 4, there is evidence of negative autocorrelation. Now let us see how we actually implement this. How we actually implement this. For this, our null hypothesis is rho is equal to 0 versus rho not equal to 0. Rho is equal to 0 versus rho is not equal to 0. Now, the mechanism is for running the D test is, the first step is you regress pi on explanatory variables, obtain the residuals, compute D. It will be automatically calculated by the softwares, given the sample size. So the first step is compute D, and given n and number of explanatory variables, DL and DU from the table given. DL and DU from the table given. Given for the sample size and the number of explanatory variables, and follow the decision rules which we consider. Our null hypothesis is that H0, rho is equal to 0 versus H1, rho is not equal to 0. We calculate D, fix alpha also at 5% or 1%. Now, as I told you, the range of D is between 0 and 4. Always keep this in mind, between 0 and 4. We have the model, we have D from the sample, we have the critical D values, DL and DU, for given sample size and number of explanatory variables, alpha is fixed. Now, if D less than DU, if D is less than DL, reject H0. There is evidence of positive autocorrelation. You know, autocorrelation can be positive or negative. So, a value less than 2, greater than 0, evidence of positive autocorrelation. Greater than 2 and less than 4, evidence of negative autocorrelation. So if D calculated from the sample is less than DL, evidence of positive autocorrelation. 2, D is less than DU, greater than DL, DU, less than DL, greater than DU, then the test is inconclusive. The test is inconclusive regarding whether there is autocorrelation, whether there is autocorrelation or not. So if the value of D from the sample fall in this region, we expand the critical region up to DU. If D is less than DU, then we conclude that there is evidence of positive autocorrelation. If the value of D falls in the indecision, in the zone of indecision, that is D is between DL and DU, we take DU as the critical region. If D is less than DU, we conclude that there is positive autocorrelation. So this is the area of positive autocorrelation. Up to this also positive autocorrelation. Positive autocorrelation. And the third is, if the value of D is greater than DU but less than 4 minus less than 4 minus DL, that is D is greater than DU but less than 4 minus DL, then D is between 4 minus DU and less than DU, do not reject H0. There is no autocorrelation. No autocorrelation. That is, if the value of D is greater than DU, so less than D, 4 minus DL. Do not reject H0. And if the value of D, this is 4 minus DU. If the value of D is less than 4 minus DU, greater than 4 minus DL, then it is the zone of indecision. We cannot take a decision regarding whether there is autocorrelation or not. Zone of indecision. In this case, we use 4 minus DL. 4 minus DL. If the value of D is greater than 4 minus DL, that is up to this, we conclude that there is negative autocorrelation. We take the critical value as 4 minus DL. 4 minus DL. There is evidence of negative autocorrelation. And the last, if D is less than 4, greater than 4 minus DU, then reject H0, there is evidence of negative autocorrelation. Evidence of negative autocorrelation. So this is the Durbin-Watson D. Always remember this. But there is one point I want to say. In most applications, H0 is rho is equal to 0. Tested against H1, rho is greater than 0. Because autocorrelation in most cases is positive. Autocorrelation in most cases is positive. You will not get negative autocorrelation. Then the strategy is very simple. If D is less than DL, positive autocorrelation. If it is in the zone of indecision, the critical region is expanded to DU. If D is less than DU, again there is positive autocorrelation. Then if D is between these two, there is no autocorrelation, positive or negative. So keep this point also in your mind. Also remember, you just go through any book of econometrics for examples. And suppose that DL is 1.4, DU is 1.6 in an application for a given number of n and x. And suppose that the D calculated from the sample is 1.2. There is evidence of positive autocorrelation. Suppose that it is 1.5. It is in the D from the sample is in the zone of indecision, but you can conclude that there is positive autocorrelation. If the value of D from the sample is say 1.8, etc., or 2.1, something like this, 1.8, etc., greater than DU, then there is no autocorrelation, positive or negative. So this is the D, Durbin-Watson D test. It is applicable if and only if X is strictly exogenous. That is, only if the model satisfies all the classical assumptions. The model should not contain specifically lagged values of dependent variable as explanatory variable. If lagged values of dependent variable is used as explanatory variables, then the value of D will be equal to 2. And we will conclude that there is no autocorrelation. And remember this always in your minds. 0, DL, DU, 2, 4 minus DL, 4 minus DU, and 4. Evidence of positive, evidence of negative. No autocorrelation. Two zones of indecision, but positive, negative. That is it. This is Durbin-Watson D statistics.